Good morning, students. So this is the 8th video lecture of the CS304, that is digital system. And here in this video lecture, we discuss about Boolean algebra part 1. We cover this topic in 2 video lectures. So in this part 1 video lecture, we discuss about the basics of Boolean algebra. What is the requirement of the Boolean algebra? And then we discuss the Boolean laws, Boolean theorems, and how we can implement this Boolean theorem in the designing process of digital circuit and system. So now we move to the forward. These are the outlines, prerequisite, always required before starting a new topic, objective. What is the objective? Boolean algebra. What is the Boolean algebra? We discuss here. What is Boolean laws, different type of laws, and then discuss the laws one by one, AND laws, OR laws, inversion laws, commutative laws, associative laws, distributive laws, how these laws are used in the designing process. Then we go for the exercise based on these discussion. Finally, we have some learning outcomes, and at the last we have references. So these are overall outlines of the video lecture. Now we move to the prerequisites. So the basic knowledge of AND, OR, AND NOT operator, because in Boolean algebra we have 3 important laws: AND laws, OR laws, NOT laws, that is inversion laws. So we have a basic knowledge about this. So there is a requirement of prerequisite as a basic knowledge of all these 3 operators. So this is the second prerequisite requirement, as a basic knowledge of De Morgan's theorem, because when we solve the expression with the help of Boolean algebra, there is a requirement of taking the complement of the expression. At that time we have some knowledge of De Morgan's theorem. There is a 2 De Morgan's theorem student already cover in BT 104. So there is a little bit requirement of the De Morgan's theorem. Now we move to the objective. There is always some objective. So here we have objective, like how Boolean algebra is used to analyze and simplify the digital circuit, because finally we design the digital circuit. So during the designing, there is a requirement of the simplification, because when we simplify the expression, the designing process is easy, the circuit is less complex, and the overall cost is also reduced. So this can be done with the help of Boolean algebra. So it is a great advantage, and objective of the Boolean algebra is used in analysis and simplification of the digital designing circuit. Simplification of Boolean expression with the help of Boolean laws and theorem. Definitely we use different type of law and theorems for simplification of Boolean expression. Again, when we simplify any expression, so it is very easy when we design the expression. So this is second objective. Use of Boolean algebra in the designing of combinational and sequential circuit. Finally, we design the circuit, either maybe combinational and sequentially. Boolean algebra are basically used in the designing of combinational. It is mostly used in the designing of combinational circuit if we are compared with combinational and sequential. So finally, we design a digital circuit. So that's why in the designing process, there is an important role of Boolean algebra, because it reduces the expression, and due to this, the designing is very simple. So these are the objectives of the Boolean algebra. Now we move to the Boolean algebra, discuss about the Boolean algebra. So it is invented by George Boolean the year 1854. It uses only binary number 0 and 1. It is also called binary algebra or logical algebra, because in digital we use always the symbol logic 0 and logic 1. Logic 0 means low voltage, logic 1 means high voltage. Logic 0 means off, logic 1 means on. So we use only two symbols, that is logic 0 and 1. That's why it is known as binary algebra or logical algebra. Because we use only two symbols, that's why it is very easy to implement the Boolean algebra. Complement of variable is represented by over var. Here the complement is represented by over var symbol, dash symbol. So we move to the another point. ORing is important operation. I am previously discussed there. AND, OR, and NOT is important operator. So ORing is a variable is represented by a plus sign between them. Suppose that we want to OR between A and B. So we use the plus sign A plus B. So this is used in Boolean algebra, this notation. Now we move to ending of a variable is represented by dot sign between them. Suppose that we want to ending operation between x and y. So we have x dot y. So we have three important laws: inversion law, OR law, AND law. Inversion law is represented by over var dash symbol, OR is represented by plus symbol, AND is represented by dash symbol, dot symbol. Boolean laws. So we have different type of Boolean laws. We have commutative law. We have associative law. We have AND law. We have distributive properties, inversion law, OR law. So these are some laws and the properties, or maybe a theorem of the Boolean laws. Here in this lecture, we discuss all these laws and theorems one by one. Initially, we discuss AND or inversion law. Then we discuss the property of commutative, associative, and distributive. So with the help of these laws and properties, we can easily simplify the any Boolean expression with the help of Boolean algebra. Now we move to the AND law. It is important law. So these table represent the AND law in different format: identity law, null law, inverse law, commutative law, associative law, absorption law, and De Morgan's theorem. There are different type of the laws are represented here. So the AND, in the AND, we know that we use the dot symbol between the two variables. So here, this is identity law. Suppose that one dot A. So this is the product one dot A. So when we multiplied any value with 1, the answer is in the form of variable. So when we have 1 multiply with A equal to A, when we multiply with any variable with 0, the answer is equivalent to 0. So when we multiply the same variable, student concentrating here, it is important point, A into A. Here in Boolean, we have not A square. A into A equal to A. Suppose that we multiply A into A into A number of times, we have only A. So when a same variable multiply number of times, the answer is in the form of single variable. This is the inverse law. When a variable is multiplied by its complement, the answer is always equivalent to 0. We check that all the law one by one. So this is the inversion law. When any variable multiply by its complement form, it is important, then equivalent to 0. A into A bar equal to 0. This is commutative law. Product of A dot B equal to B dot A. Changing the position doesn't matter in the form of results. So the commutative law in case of AND law, A dot B equal to B dot A. Here, AND law in the form of associative law. multiply a and b, and the result is multiply with c. So inside the bracket we have ab multiply with c equal to, if multiply b and c and the result is multiplied by a, in both the case LHS equal to RHS. So the result is same in both the case, ab multiply with c or a multiply with bc. So this belongs to associative law, and here we use the dot between the variables, that so by this associative law representing the AND laws. Distributive law, a plus bc equal to a plus b into a plus c. So this is the distribution here, a plus bc equal to a plus b into a plus c, and this entity is proved in upcoming slides. So student concentrating here, we prove this entity a plus bc equal to a plus b into a plus b, how the LHS equal to RHS. This, the proof of this entity is coming in the upcoming slides. Absorption law, a multiply with a plus b equal to a, we also checked it, LHS equal to RHS. So this is absorption law. And De Morgan's theorem, for in case of AND laws, a dot b equal to a bar plus b bar. Here dot is replaced by plus, because in AND law a and b multiply by dot sign, so this dot is replaced by plus sign. In De Morgan's theorem, dot is replaced by plus sign. Then we have two variable a and b, and then taking the complement of individual variable. Okay, so this is the De Morgan's theorem, and we are detail discuss De Morgan's theorem in the upcoming lectures, that is the video lecture part 2 of Boolean algebra. So we discuss here this laws in detail. These are some AND rules. 0 into 0 equal to 0. With the help of this, we describe these laws in detail. 0 into 1, 0. When multiplied 0 with any variable, answer in 0. 1.0 is 0. So in first three case, when multiplied any variable with 0, answer in the form of 0. Then we move. 1 into 1 equal to 1. A into 1, A. So when we multiplied any variable with A, answer in the form of variable. A dot 0, again 0. When we multiply with 0, answer is 0. A into A equal to A. This is like here, we also consider this law. And A into A bar, this is important in the case, last case. So this is A into A bar, means A complement. So this law is just like inverse law, A into A complement equal to 0. So we have checked one by one. Suppose that 1 into A equal to A. So we put, if we put in 1 into A, if we put A equal to 0, student concentrating here. So this is 1, in place of A we put 0. Okay. 1 into 0 equal to 1. If we put A equal to 0. Okay. If we put A equal to 1 in first law, 1 into 1 equal to 1. So if we are concentrating here, the result is always follow the A. If the value of A is 0, here the output is 0, because 1 multiply with 0, output is 0. So here we put the value of A. So when value of A is 0, answer is 0. When value of A is 1, answer is 1. So in first entity, output is always follow the value A. So that's why 1 dot A equal to A. In second, 0 into 1, 0 into A. So we put A equal to 0, 0 into 0 equal to, again 0. In this, we put A equal to 0, 0 into 0. Again 0 into A, so in place of A we put 1, so 1 dot 0 is 0. So here in second entity, we put A equal to 0 and A equal to 1, but the answer is always 0. So answer is doesn't depend on the value of A, it is always 0. That's why the answer is 0. So we can check each and every entity one by one. Suppose that here in third, A into A equal to A, we put A equal to 1, 1 dot 1 equal to 1. We put 0, 0 dot 0 equal to 0. So we are simply saying that when we put A 1, answer is 1. When we put A 0, answer is 0. So when answer is follow the value of a. So a into a is always equivalent to a. This is third entity, so we can check easily. So suppose that we want to check this. This is a a into a bar. So when we put a equal to 1 and a bar means we put a equal to 1 in inverse law. A complement means complement of 1, because value of a is 1 and we are taking the complement. So complement of 1 is 0 here. So the answer is 0. Suppose that we put a equal to 0 in inverse law. So a equal to 0, a equal to 0, complement of 0 is 1. Answer is 0. So answer is always 0. Doesn't depend on the value. Okay, so yeah, answer is 0. So we can check every entity by putting the value. So this is the overall AND laws. Okay. Now we move to the OR laws. Here in the OR laws we have these rules here. So these are again the same laws, but in the case of OR laws, that's why the dot operator is replaced by plus operator, because in OR law we use the plus operator. So dot operator is replaced by plus operator here. So identity law again, 0 plus a equal to a. When we add 0 in any variable, answer is equivalent to variable. 1 plus a equal to 1, a plus a equal to a plus a bar equal to 1. When complement and its variable is added, the answer is equal to 1. In the case of AND law, a into a bar equal to 0. But in case of OR law, a plus a bar equal to 1. In case of commutative law, a plus b equal to b plus a. Either we add a plus b or either we add b plus a, both are equal. In case of associative law, with respect to OR laws, a plus b added with c equal to a plus a added with b plus c. Distributive law, a dot b plus c equal to a b plus a c. Absorption law, a plus a b equal to a. And De Morgan's theorem for OR laws, a plus b whole complement equal to dot plus sign is replaced by dot, and both variable a and b and taking individual complement. So in De Morgan's we just change the variables and taking the complement of individual variable. Now we move to the OR laws. This is important for discussion purpose. So 0 plus 0 equal to 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 1, because in Boolean we have only 0 and 1. So that is 1 plus 1 equal to 1. This belongs to this. Suppose that we put a equal to 1, 1 plus 1 equal to 1. So a plus 0 equal to a. Again, a plus 1 equal to 1, and a plus a bar equal to 1. This is this. So we can put the value and check the rules. Suppose that in first case we put a equal to 0. So 0 plus a. So this is 0. Again we put here 0. So this is 0 plus 0 equal to 0. Okay. And 0 plus a equal to 1 in this case. So we have 1. So the value of output is depend on value of input. If we a 0, output a 1, output 1. So 0 plus a equal to a. Okay. Suppose that we want to check this entity, inverse law, a plus a complement, a equal to 0 plus 0 complement of 0 is 1, because you put a equal to 0, 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Okay. If we put a equal to 1 plus a complement of 1 is 0, again this is 0. So in both the cases answer is 1. So here the answer is 1. We can check easily. Suppose that commutative law we check. Suppose that we put a 0 b 1. So we put 0 a equal to 0 plus b equal to 1 here. So we have a plus b equal to b plus 1, b plus a. So b is 1, a is 0. So 1 plus 0 is 1, or 0 plus 1 is 1. So LHS is equal to RHS. So prove the commutative. So we prove all the rules by putting the value of variable either 0 and 1. Okay, so these are the OR laws. Now we move to the inverse law. So this law uses the NOT operation, inverter. The inversion law states that double inversion of a variable result in the original variable itself. Like when we are taking the A double complement, the answer in the form of variable. In other words, we can say student concentrating here. If there is an even number of times a complement over a variable, suppose that there is a 4-time complement over a variable, the answer is in the form of variable without complement. Suppose that A complement, 4 times complement, answer is in the form of A. A double complement, answer is in the form of A, answer in the form of variable. When the complement is in odd number of times, then the answer in the variable, in the form of variable with complement. Suppose A triple time complements, A complement, answer is equal to A complement. So here the inverse law states that double inversion of variable in the original variable itself. Okay, so we can easily prove this thing or entity by this. Suppose that we have 0 and we are taking the complement of double. So first we solve inside complement. So upper side complement replace as it is, and 0 complement of this inside complement solve. Complement of 0 is 1. So 1 complement of solve, and then complement of 1 is 0. So finally the answer in the form of variable. Okay, so here we prove a one important entity which discussed in previous slide. A plus BC equal to A plus B into A plus C. How we can say that the LHS equal to RHS? So we prove this entity here. So we start with RHS. A plus B into A plus C. So multiply this. We have 4 terms. A into A, first term, plus A into C, second term, plus A into B, third term, and B into C, the last term. So in the RHS, but in the LHS we have A plus BC. Okay, so we concentrate over the VC. That's why VC are taking separate here, because in LHS the VC are basically having a term. So we have this term, we are taking separate. Now all these 3 terms are inside a bracket. So what is the next step here? We are use the rule A dot A. This is AND law. So we know that A dot A equal to A, because 1 dot 1 is 1, 0 dot 0 is 0. So this A dot A is A, AC, AB plus BC. Now we are taking the variable A is common. So we have 1 plus B plus C plus BC. Student concentrating here, it is important rule. 1 plus something is always 1. This 1 plus C plus B plus D plus whatever, 1 plus something is always 1. How we can prove that? 1 plus something. Something in Boolean or in digital, something is maybe 0 or 1, because we use only 2 symbols. So 1 plus something, that is something is maybe 0. 1 plus something and something is maybe 1. These 2 possibilities are here. So 1 plus 0 is 1. You know that. And 1 plus 1 is 1. So 1 plus something may be 0 and 1 plus something may be 1. It is always equivalent to 1. So that's why this 1 plus B plus C is equivalent to 1, because 1 plus something, this is the portion of something. This is the 1, and then this is the C plus B, and this C plus B is maybe 0 or 1. When 1 plus 0 is always equivalent to 1. When 1 plus 1, this is also equivalent to 1. So this 1 plus something is always 1. So the next step is here. A dot, this whole value is 1. Okay, so this is the value here. This is 1 plus BC. Okay, this is 1 plus BC, and 1 is multiplied with A. So because this whole value is 1, A dot 1, A dot 1 is A. So we have next step A plus BC. So the LHS equal to RHS. Here the formula are used, which is A dot A equal to A, and 1 plus something is 1. So these are the formula which are used. So LHS equal to RHS. Now we move to the commutative property of addition. So this is the symbol A plus B or either B plus A. This is the OR gate which are added. Either we add A and B, either we add B and A. The answer is same. So this is in parallel form. They are adding to each other. Either we have A here and B here. Either we have B and A are interchanging the position, but the result is same. So we have A plus B equal to B plus A. So this is the commutative property of addition. By changing the position of A and B, the result is always same in both the logic diagram. Now we move to the commutative property of multiplication. So this is the AND gate, because which is used in the case of multiplication. So we have A dot B here, or here position of A and B are interchanged, but the result is same. It is also a B dot A. So A dot B equal to B dot A. In series, we have A first and B is second, but the answer is A dot B. Here we are changing the position of B and A. This is again B dot A. A dot B is equivalent to B dot A. So this proves the commutative property of multiplication. Suppose that we put A equal to 1 and B equal to 0. So 1 dot 0 is 0, or 0 dot 1 is 0. So interchanging the position of A and B, the result is always same. So this proves the commutative property of multiplication. Associative property of addition. So here we add A plus B. So we have A plus B by using OR gate, and then add C. So output of this circuit is A plus B plus C. And here B plus C, so giving the input as an OR gate, B plus C added first, then added with A. So the answer is A plus B plus C. Both the answer is same. Either we use A plus B plus C, either we use A plus B plus C. So in both the logic symbol, if we are doing this, the LHS is always equal to RHS. So this belongs to the property of associative property of addition. Now we move to the associative property of multiplication here. So here we multiply AB first. So this here we multiply AB first. Okay. Here we multiply AB first and then multiply with C. In this case, here we BC multiply first and then multiply with A. But the answer in both the cases are same. So here in diagram, so here B and C multiply first and then multiply with A. So this is this LHS A dot BC. While here AB multiplied first, this one, and multiply with C. So in both the cases, if we put value of here ABC 1, 1, 1 into 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 1 into 1 is 1. So when we put any value between 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, the LHS is always equivalent to RHS. Okay, so this belong to associative property of multiplication. Now we move to the distributive property. So in distributive property, that is A plus BC equal to A plus B into A plus C. So AB plus AC. So AB multiplied here first. This is AB multiplied by this AND gate, and this is AC multiplied by this AND gate, then given as the input of OR gate. So this is represent the RHS. While here B plus C added first in case of LHS, and then multiply by A with the help of AND gate. So in both the cases, LHS equal to RHS. Here this is a parallel combination. So this is B plus C multiply with A represent LHS. While AB and AC are in series, so they produce AB and AC term, and both are in parallel, then added to each other. This represent the RHS. So this in this distributive property, LHS is always equal to RHS. So now these are some exercise. In the Boolean algebra, a variable has a different states, how many number of states, AND operation is equivalent to division, union, intersection, none. We discussed AND operator already. OR operation is equivalent to division, union, intersection, none. Prove that by using the Boolean laws and entities. So these are exercises based on previous discussion. Now these are some learning outcomes. Boolean algebra used in simplification of Boolean expression. We already discussed that. With the help of Boolean laws and theorems, we reduce and simplify the expression, which is also helpful in the designing purpose. Implementation of Boolean algebra is very easy. Only two variables, logic 0 and logic 1, are used. That's why we used Boolean algebra in the designing process for simplification purpose. Boolean algebra used in the designing of digital circuit, because finally we want to design the digital circuits. That's why we use the Boolean algebra for simplification of expression, and then we use in designing. So this is the overall discussion. So in the upcoming video lectures, we discuss, that is the Boolean algebra part 2. We solve some other Boolean expression simplification along with De Morgan's theorem, because De Morgan's theorem is also important part of the Boolean algebra, which is widely used in the designing process. So these are some references we used. Thank you, students.